Hey guys, listen up. One of the most dangerous things for a fight is the start of the fight. And I want to talk about that because I don't think enough is really considered, because we say in our system, we say in our training, and we can get kind of this snobbish attitude that since we're doing scientific self-defense, that we don't have to worry about these crude haymakers and so forth. Yes, we do. Yes, you do. We should train for it. So here's a couple of things to consider to help you train for the start of the fight, the initiation, the launch sequence that gets fights going. Here we go. It's generally the overhand right, or some variation of kind of a right cross coming from a street fighter. And this is a dangerous punch for you if you block it with your face. It's a dangerous punch for him because a lot of momentum on it if he misses you. So you want to consider that and consider it soberly. So here we go. Again, number one, you've got to maintain your emotional fitness and understand the precursors for violence and how they start. So as martial artists, we should always be polite, right? We shouldn't be, we shouldn't be engaging in things that we shouldn't be doing, and maybe bringing some negative attention to ourselves. So, you know, practice the art of fighting without fighting. It's always a great way to go. We've got some other videos on that. But one, if you just walk around being a jerk, saying things that are really stupid, like you don't know who you're messing with. Well, that's the dumbest thing anyone says, because you don't know who you're messing with either, right? So always be polite, always be nice, always be respectful. Always practice the two exits. If things start getting kind of heated, practice the two exits. You leave. If you don't need any reason for you to be there, leave. That's the first exit. The second exit is him. If you have a place that you need to be in and someone's getting kind of hostile, try to think of a way to get them to leave and to help them, to make them think it's their idea. That's the best way to go. You're not there to win an ego match. Trust me, nobody goes, it gets into the middle of an argument with a heated argument with an irrational person and says, you know, you say something to them about how contradictory they are or irrational they are. I never heard anybody go, yeah, man, I am. I'm constantly using ad hominem attacks and this, therefore that fallacy. Thank you for alerting me to that. It's hard to win an argument with an intelligent person. It's impossible to win one with a fool. Don't try and stay there and argue, okay? Try to get them to leave. And then if you can't, I can call the police. So in doing so, watch your positioning. Don't stand out in the middle of nowhere, have your hands down, put your hands in your pockets. Not a good idea. That's when that punch is gonna come, okay? A lot of people just get dumb, and I don't know, they're worried about looking uncool or looking upset. Just go, hey, dude, I don't want any trouble. Try to get some space between you guys. Don't let them inside of arm's reach. Don't do that. Let them stay back. You can get like a barrier between you, a physical barrier, like a desk or a counter or a car. That's what you want to do. All right. Don't let them in your space, and especially don't have your hands down, because that punch is coming. So once you get all that, again, now maintain once again your emotional fitness. Don't lose your temper, and make sure you're breathing. Make sure you keep your eyes moving. That's another thing that happens in fights, is that you can kind of get tunnel vision, and the nerves can start playing havoc with you. All right. Watch for the signs that a punch could be coming. Normally, a guy starts going this way, he's looking to launch that punch. He's getting into range for a reason. He's not getting into range to give you cash or cupcakes, okay? He's getting into range if he's being hostile, to try to get a shot at you. So guard that flank, keep moving around a little bit if you need to. Now, if he starts to launch, if you have a right to be there, and we're not going to cover everything, but again, morally and legally, you have a right to be doing what you're doing. You can clearly articulate why you're in fear. And he comes into that range, get ready to hit him. That's your first defense, is to try to stop hit this guy if he starts to launch at you. Try to hit him before he gets off, as he's starting to launch. And again, we're presuming that you have the moral and legal right to do that. You have a place you have a right to be, and you didn't initiate the violence in terms of, you know, instigating it. Number two, he gets that punch off. The best thing is get ready to move. Okay, so if that right hand's coming, you can just step back quick, and you'll notice how I'm covering. I'm doing that. I'm not using a sport-based cover with the back of my hand. This is not a good defense. That's just going to break my hand or, you know, cut me or so forth. Okay. So I want to make sure as he steps to me, I'm moving and getting out of the way. And then immediately I can counter him or shove him off of me, you know, or hit him with a toaster oven, something like that. Make sure you're ready to move, because naturally, and this is where people have a problem. If you look at like the gun safety rules of people who, well, don't worry, they ain't loaded. And they're negligent because they don't think an accident can happen to them. If you're sitting at home thinking, oh, I'm gonna be cool, and you don't think nerves are gonna hit you, you're playing with fire. You gotta calm down and get ready to move. As soon as that burst of action happens, get ready to move. If you don't think you might freeze and end up doing this or this, you need a trainer. Keep training, having somebody step to you quick and then match that movement so you take the motion away from them. So as they're stepping to you, that missed it. The gem that comes in with that, by the way, is if this guy's swinging at you and it's not a fist, it's a knife or a set of brass knuckles or something's on that fist and you're not there, it doesn't hurt you, you know. But if you're standing your ground, then, you know, if any of those other variables are there, you could have a problem. So movement's always better than standing your ground right there, unless you have absolute certainty you know what's coming. That begs a couple of other questions. We'll get into that some other time. The next thing you can do is, of course, you can block that or jam it. That punch is coming in. That's a bit more dangerous because you don't always know the angle that punch is coming. That's why we're not doing a demo with this, right? Because if you say, when people ask me this, well, how do you block a right hand? Well, whose right hand? You know, you think of the difference just in boxing. Look at the difference between Tommy Hearns' right hand and Sugar Ray Leonard's. Everyone throws this shot different. And you may be wrong. You have to be perfect. They have to be close because they initiated, right? So the better way to go, like I said, is a move. You can jam it or you can cover it completely. Not a fan of those, but if you have to do it, you have to do it. Sometimes we end up having to do something we don't want to do. Like go see your mother-in-law. Everybody has to do some things they'd really rather not do. That might be the case. So if you get beat to the punch, you can't get out. You can't beat them to the punch. You can't get out of the way quick. You might cover or jam that way. Those are your other options for a very bad scenario. But lastly, again, takes time to seriously consider the initiation, the launch sequence of a street fight. It's not going to be touch gloves, bow, and let's get it on. You know, Mills Lane is going to come out of the corner. Let's get it on. Not going to hear that. There's going to be a sucker punch type of variety. That's the problem. The ambush, you got to consider this seriously. A lot of people don't do this enough. They don't train for it emotionally. Yeah, that's a problem. I'll say one other thing about the emotional fitness. Every time somebody's a victim of something, you get the three stupids. One, I can't believe that happened to me. What makes you think you're so special? Right? I mean, everybody, you know, you step in front of a train or a train hits you. You know, I can't believe it happened to me. Well, you're on a train track, stupid. Get off the train track. I can't believe they did that. That's the second stupid. Everyone's capable of, you know, violence. That's the problem. Some people more so than others, but that's always one of the things people say when they're a victim of violence. I can't believe that happened to me. I can't believe they did that. And the third dumb thing to say is, I can't believe that happened here. You know, that's just idiotic. Violence happens when people are vulnerable. Don't be vulnerable. Try not to leave yourself in bad positions. And then get ready. If the signs are there, this guy's getting aggressive, you know, he starts grooming, you know, he's just pulling his pants up. So doing it, the punch is probably on its way. Take that seriously and you're gonna be better prepared for it. But if you spend all of your time training for things, whether, you know, it's in the school and you're doing a lot of chi sao or you're doing sparring or whatever, and those are good and necessary things for skill development. But you can have all those things ready to go and then be really stupid and lose the initiation sequence and get clocked with a haymaker, and that's not gonna go too well for you. So that would be all for naught. All the training you did is because you screwed up that initiation and the sucker punch. Two things for a sucker punch to score, guys, a sucker and a punch, right? So don't be a sucker. Pay attention to your surroundings. And I will say this too, when people say be aware of your surroundings, your subconscious is gonna be serious. Your subconscious is like, if I say to my subconscious, hey, write the perfect poem, my subconscious is gonna go, I don't know how to do that, I suck at poetry. Because I, you know. But if I say, write a bad poem about a tree, my subconscious is gonna go, I can do that, right? It's gonna do that. So if you go be aware of your surroundings, your subconscious, not being full of crap, is gonna go, I'm not omniscient. And so a lot of people just stop paying attention to their surroundings because they don't know what to specify. You're looking for something that jumps off your baseline. Somebody that's acting, you know, in an irrational way, and they start breaching your reactionary gap. That's person that should draw your attention. So, you know, no one's aware of everything going on around them. You need to be aware of certain things, in particular, a possibility of an unavoidable violent encounter. Those are things you need to be ready for, be ready to move, encounter, and so forth. If you don't pay attention to that, you don't train for it, especially emotionally, because it's going to be sudden, right? Then you can end up freezing. And this is the worst thing to do right here. right? Naturally, you go, crap. And that punch is coming over the top and your chin's right there in the way of it. And that's what I mean when I said, it's gonna be a very dangerous punch for you if you block it with your face, okay? So that's pretty much one of the most dangerous things going on out there is that initiation, that big right hand, that haymaker a lot of people throw. Some people throw the left hook, but more often than not, you're gonna see the right hand. Get ready for that emotionally, mentally, put some prep time into that and think about it and do some walkthroughs in the gym with it. Have somebody just, obviously safely, you know, kind of go through that so you can get used to that burst of energy coming out of a neutral state. If you don't do that, you're always working on bowing or, you know, kind of cooperation drills and so forth, that can leave you vulnerable. So pay attention to that. Hopefully this helped. You know, please click the like and subscribe button if you can get some more stuff. You know, click the bell too, there's a bell over there so you can get notifications. That's important because, you know, whenever we're doing something, you want to know, trust me. Anyway, catch you guys next time.